Alright, can you guys hear me? I think I've got everything set up correctly. I don't know how loud the game volume is. I hope it's okay. Well, let me know if it's not. I'm a bit late because I was trying to play around with the resolution options, and this game doesn't really have very many. I can play in full screen or window, and I don't think I can actually change the size of the window, which is a bit annoying for the live stream, but otherwise it's not a problem. Anyway, I've already played the first two areas in this game. The first one's pretty easy, but I'm already starting to struggle a bit with the second one. But anyway, I'll play the game from the beginning because there's a lot of cool animations that I want to show off. Stream is laggy. Oh, that's not good. Well, I don't know if I have much control over that. It looks okay in my preview. I don't know. Oops. I think I can get an achievement here if an animal knocks the ball into the hole. Let's see if I can do that. Did that count? I don't think so. There we go. I don't know if golf is very fun to watch, but I hope you guys enjoy the animations in this game. And I'm also not particularly good at it, so I don't know if this I don't know if I'll put on a good show. But these levels I've played before, so I'm okay at these ones. Nope. No. That was bad. That was really bad. Thank you. There was an earlier version of this game that came out like I think 10 years ago on flash game websites. I haven't played it recently, so I don't really know how it compares, but it had a very similar art style. I'm assuming this one is like a higher resolution because it's not a browser game anymore. Oops. Let's try that again. Nice. Oh, no. Not my best efforts. Let's try that again. Last time I did this level, I had no problem. I managed to bounce it off the wall perfectly, so I'll just have to be more careful. Oh, nope. Oh no. Can I do this? I don't know. Okay, fine. That was pretty bad. Almost made it perfect. Oh well, close enough. Is there a give up state? Well, I think you can just respawn your ball, but I don't know if there's any kind of give up thing. This level's tricky, it has really weird gravity. There we go. Oh, if you do bad enough that you can't continue. I don't know, I've never done that badly. Maybe. Gonna do this one. There we go. See, I'm good at some of these levels. I'm not very good at this one, though. Yeah, that was bad. This game is too forgiving? Well, this is kind of the first few levels, right? It gets a lot harder. Though, you know, I'm not really big on golf games, so I kind of like if it's more forgiving. Yeah, the holes do have a pretty big hitbox. It's very forgiving. Yeah, if you get it kind of anywhere in the general area of the hole, it'll kind of get sucked in a little bit. Later on, you'll kind of see why that's useful, because the levels get quite a bit crazier. And I think it would be really punishing otherwise. Oh no. Yeah, I messed that up. I didn't see that that corner was curved, so I made a really stupid shot. Alright, let's see if we can get straight into the door from here. Nice. Am I still updating EBF5? Well, on mobile, there's still a few issues I need to fix. Not very much, it's almost finished. There's just iCloud on iOS doesn't work, and there's a very rare black screen issue when you start the game that a few people have encountered. I need to fix that as well. But for the most part, the mobile game's finished. I have a few ideas that I might add later to mobile and PC versions, but you know, maybe not anytime soon. Someone on YouTube was doing a summons only challenge, and I thought it would be fun if I made that one of the official challenge modes for the game. Give people an excuse to use a lot of the summons they never would have used otherwise. And yeah, that might be a fun mode to add to the game later, if I have nothing else to work on. And while I'm talking, I'm playing very badly here. Come on. That's hardly fair. This level's almost like a puzzle. You kind of have to find the best, kind of the best angle to cover as many of these tiles as possible. But for me, it's a bit of guesswork as well. That was pretty bad. Not my best, but also not my worst. Yeah, my best score here is, minus 24 over par. As opposed to what I got this time, which was minus 6. So, basically that means I beat the par number of holes by 6. I don't know how golf scoring works. I have to look it up for this game. Apparently, I think that the best score you can get is albatross, and then it's eagle, birdie, then par, and then bogey. And then if you get less than bogey, that's really bad. And there's a very small time penalty in this game as well, so if you, like, just spend a long time just looking at the stage, you slowly lose a bit of score. But as you can see here, it's not really a big factor in the final score. Mainly you just want to, hit the ball as few times as possible. Anyway, let's try some of the other game modes. Let's try these geometry trips. Let's see. I'm gonna play from the beginning rather than continue where I was. Let's see. What are these modifiers? Nah, that seems hard. I'm gonna play with the normal ball. Oops. What's the best course of action here? Well, that was bad. Anyway, the reason I'm kind of playing this game is because this is actually still a Flash game. The original game came out like 10 years ago and was a browser game, but this one, which is for mobile and for Steam, is actually still made in Flash. So it's not actually a 3D game engine. I think it's just it's all 2D, just made to look like 3D. So there's some interesting trickery going on there. Oh. That was an awful shot. How do I get around this? Wow. Alright, let's see. What do I do here? I just come out blasting. Oh, that was a collectible. Alright, cool. No! Is the Hollow Soldier card in EBF5 a Hollow Knight reference? Yes, I think that's pretty obvious. And am I gonna use the acid boots for anything? Nope, definitely not. That's the whole point of the joke. How'd I get in here? Can I get it in from here if I use this bump? Almost. I think most of these stages are designed so that you can get the ball in one go, if you know what you're doing. How do I get this collectible? Oh, okay, fair enough. Thank you. Nope. Am I excited for Silk Song, and am I gonna stream it? I don't know. Is that game still in development? I used to follow the developer on Twitter, but I think he's been working on it for a really long time now, hasn't he? Oh no, shit. I'm thinking of a different game. Silk Song is the what's the DLC for Hollow Knight, right? I was thinking of a different game called called Bard Song or something else. I don't know. I actually haven't played very much of Hollow Knight. I started playing it and I didn't really get into it. It wasn't really doing anything for me. Maybe I need to try playing it a bit longer, but I didn't really like the first half hour of the game, so I don't know. Do I have to go all the way around to get that rainbow ball? Well, I do want to get all the collectibles at any cost, so here we go. This game looks like a mobile port. Well, what does that even mean? There's a lot of games on Steam that you could say that about. Well, to be fair, I guess it is a mobile port. It did come out on mobile first. And I think that is kind of the intended platform. But there's no reason you shouldn't play this on Steam. I think it's more comfortable to play it on a computer than on a phone. Anyway, I'll go back to the better looking levels because these ones, they're fun to play, but they're a bit less visually interesting, right? So, let's see. Can I take a break here? Yeah, I think I can just leave and come back here later. So, let's go to avoid bursting the inflatable lifts. Okay, there's some achievements here that I'm probably not going to be able to get. But I'll try. It basically looks like there's a few specific stages you have to beat perfectly, which might be tricky. Yeah, don't explode the bomb, don't burn yourself in the sun, and don't burst any inflatable lifts. That's going to be hard. Yeah, my previous score is here. Not very good. 36 points over par. Not great. So let's see if I can do better this time. What? How did that miss? Oh no. My controls have gotten weird. Okay, there we go. Yeah, so I think I get an achievement here if I don't burst any of these platforms. And these first two are fine, but this one here, this one will explode if you stay too long on it. So let's see if I can get a perfect shot here. All right. At least it didn't explode. Okay, good. All right, I got the achievements. Yeah, there was a guy stuck in an orange cube, huh? But yeah, that's what I mean. The animations are really cool in this game. And I think even if you're not a big fan of golf games, I think it's really worth checking out just for the really creative level design. Oh, what? I missed it completely. Oh, almost. Shouldn't be so hard. I almost had it. Okay. I have to use just a little bit less than maximum power. There we go. Okay, cool. What's the best way to get through this? I don't know. Right, not so bad. What about this part though? I don't know. Can I get behind this hedge guy? I don't know. Probably not. Oh, not great. Wasn't too bad. No, you can't rotate the angle, the camera angle in this game because it's not actually a 3D game. It just has a 3D look. I think it's all actually just in 2D. And yeah, it is hard to see some of the angles for sure. But I mean, that's kind of what you get in a really kind of stylized art style. Right, it's yeah, I read some of the reviews on mobile, and like, yeah, people are complaining that some of the controls are maybe a little bit clunky, but I think that is just to kind of accommodate the weird art style. So I don't mind. If you want like a super precise golf game, this is probably not it. But I'm really enjoying this mainly for the animation. So that's okay by me. Plus, I don't play a lot of golf games, so I can't really tell how it compares to other ones. And I'm not trying to like disparage the game. I really like it. But also as you can see, I'm not that good at it, and I probably won't try to 100% it. I'm just kind of playing it casually, so it's much easier for me to look past any flaws. I just can't get this part. All right. Can I hit it through the middle here? I'm not. No, I don't think so. No. All right, I got that. Okay, it stops me here. I can get this cake here, but then I'll just fall off and die. But I think that's okay. Oh, no. Not bad. Almost. Yeah, as you can see, this next batch of levels is a lot harder than the first batch. Like, I would really need to practice this quite a lot to kind of get the strokes done correctly, because a lot of the shots need like really specific levels of power, and that's gonna take a lot of practice. Ball got stuck on something in there. Oh, this one's fun. All right. And by fun, I mean really tricky. How do I get the ball in there? Almost. I don't really know the best way to do this. You know, I'm just kind of guessing here. There we go. Like, I don't know if there's a more reliable way of doing that. That's the best I can do, really. Let's try something else. Nice. Oh, that wasn't enough power. This is harder than it looks. Or maybe I'm just making it look hard. Yeah, that was pretty bad. All right, let's be a bit more careful this time. Oh, yeah, there was an achievement for never letting your ball burn in these levels, so I've already missed my chance to get that one. But I think it's okay if your ball flies off the edge of the map, so I think it only burned up once or twice. It might not be too hard, but I'd have to. I don't know if I can like select the exact part of the level I want to play, or if I have to do this whole thing from the beginning. I'm not sure. Oh, no. I really messed up there. This should have been an easy one. How do I correct my mistake? There we go. Not too bad. Oh, now I have the bomb ball, so if it bounces too hard, it will explode. So I have to be very gentle now. And I think I get an achievement if I don't let the ball explode. There we go. No, wait, that's relic mode? Okay. Oh, yeah, okay, there's more levels with the bomb ball. Great. Nope, I've destroyed it. My bad. How do I do this without just hitting the ball harder? Oh no. I feel like that one wasn't really my fault. I can't really predict what these treadmills are gonna do. Yeah, that's quite unpredictable there. Let's see if I can do this. I spent quite a few shots trying to get this one last time, so let's see if I remember the right amount of power. Nope. Well, I did a lot better than my my previous attempt. Yeah, 20 strokes less. Pretty good. But yeah, still plenty of room for improvement. But I could probably, if I kept playing, get the par score here. It seems doable with more practice. Most of the levels were okay. You can see on the graph here that most of them are not too bad, but there's four that I really messed up badly. So if I played a few more times and got better at those ones, I think I could do a lot better. Plus, maybe I could get some of the achievements if I kept playing. The don't let your ball burn up and don't let the bomb explode. Don't seem too hard, but you have to be really careful. And maybe play the level a bit slower than normal just to get the achievements. Anyway, I've unlocked Relic Mode. I'm not really sure what this is. I'll maybe play that later, but for now, I'm gonna play the next set of levels, which is the cage. And these are probably gonna be very hard compared to what I've played so far. Oh, looks like Minecraft. Thank you.
Interesting.
What? How do I get out of this hand? Okay. Oh, I see. Okay. I think I'm supposed to land down here. This isn't going very well. Well, when did Monument Valley come out? Let me check. I think the first game, the first Wonder Punt game maybe came out before Monument Valley. Yeah, okay, this game originally came out before Monument Valley, so if anything, Monument Valley looks like this game. I'm supposed to get into the clown mouth, but how? Oh, okay, I see. Yeah, I have to fly off the hand into the clown mouth. Okay. I get it. I get it now. It's still not easy. Wow. There we go. Yeah, I mean that should have been a bit more obvious to me. Oh well. Okay, am I trying to get in here? What? Oh. Okay. This is my first time ever playing these levels, so I'm not really sure what the goal is in some of them, so I gotta activate my almonds, gotta get that noggin jogging, gotta chill out and take a moment to think before I just start blasting the ball. Oh, an eagle! I actually did something okay for once. Oh, what is this? What am I doing here? What are the red balls? Should I be hitting them or avoiding them? I think I have to hit them. No? All right, there's also a slight hill here. Okay. Oh, interesting. Okay. What am I doing here? Okay. Oh, I see. That's how it goes. Could have done that better. Oh, wow. Let's see. So, I gotta blast it over here. And then, yeah, okay, okay. There's just ramps here. Let's do this. Alright, not enough power. Still not enough? Alright, okay. How do I do this? Oh, it looks like it's gonna be windy here. All right. Okay. Yeah, there's a lot of wind, so I have to come up this way. Nice. I finally did something right. Yeah, the ramps one was tricky, but I think the trickiest part was I just didn't realize how much power I had to put into my shots. I think once I figured out the kind of the first shot, the rest were a lot easier. But yeah, the perspective is a bit tricky in some levels, but I think you just have to play through it a few times and get a bit more familiar with the layout. Alright, how do I do this? This is gonna be hard. Okay, not so bad. Pretty bad. Alright, let's see. Oh no, oh no. And I was off to such a good start. I'm gonna try going this way. Alright, much better. Okay, that's how it's done. Alright, last one over here. Well, I mean, last little checkpoints. Let's get in here. Come on. Come on! Okay. Alright. Okay, this triangle, I think, is kind of hinting at the way I should hit the ball, so just bounce it here and I'll be fine, right? No? Maybe I need to use a better angle. What? You kidding me? This level doesn't look so hard, but yeah, that was pretty tricky. Same concept. I think I have a bit more options here. Doesn't look easy though. I feel like there might be something hidden inside the frozen sandwich. But can I see the achievements? No? I don't know. Oh, did I just exit? That's not what I meant to do. Oh, continue. Okay, cool. I can continue where I was. Anyway, no problem. Yeah, this sandwich is very suspicious, but it appears there was nothing in there. Oh, really? Okay. Okay, interesting. I don't know what's going on. Let's find out. Oh, an achievement. Okay. Nice. I guess it was quite ambitious for me to try to do that part in one go. When will I end the stream? I don't know, when I get bored of playing. I might stop talking soon, though. I'm not. Oh, I just realized. Oh, yeah, okay. I thought those flying things were part of the background. I didn't realize I was bumping into them. Oops. Need to pay more attention. But yeah, I might just stop talking after a while and continue playing the game. I was gonna play it anyway, so I figured I might as well stream. I wonder if it's possible to just shoot straight through that. Probably. But I think you'd have to get the timing perfect. Was weird. I think I went straight through the wall. Very suspicious. Or maybe I bounced over it. I don't know. Okay, what am I doing here? What? Okay, I think I have to bounce from building to building. Okay. Okay, that's an interesting way to play golf. Pretty rough. Well, that's really Yeah, that was tough.
Okay, I didn't like that level. Oh no, there's more.
Okay, let's see. What's the easiest way to do this? Not too bad. All right, what am I looking at here? Oh no. Okay, I think I see what I'm supposed to do. I don't think it's gonna be easy though. I think I can do this in three shots if you stop the ball here, and then in the middle. But as you can see, that's not quite so easy. Maybe I can go straight to the second area. Let's try that. Oh, okay, that's, yeah, I'll take it. All right, yeah, I thought I could hit the ball straight from the start to here. Which maybe you can, it just didn't turn out well for me. All right. Oh no. I feel like you can probably do this level in like two shots. If you know what you're doing, but that was not easy. Alright, how did I do? Not very well. Ouch. Oh, I don't want to play again. Let's see. So, what can I do? I can go play those mini geometry levels. What were those called? Yeah, geometry trips. I could play that. I could play the cage again and try to do better, or I could try to get more of the achievements. No, wait. I can figure out what relic mode is. Let's try relic mode. I think I just try to get the collectibles, which is cool, I guess. Let's find out. Do you think I'm able to stream EBF5 on mobile? I don't know why I would want to do that. Like, why? That seems really boring. Alright, so I gotta get all the DNA. Okay. So, I think it just makes the course a bit more complicated because there's more things I have to collect along the way. But, oops. Maybe the number of strokes I'm allowed to use will be a lot higher to compensate for that. But, yeah, we'll see how it goes. I do enjoy collecting things. Energy? How does energy work? I don't know anything. Alright, okay, energy is the number of strokes I have left, okay. So I gotta collect the DNA to get more energy? Interesting. I can get into this. Thank you. Oh, I don't lose energy if I collect more right away. Interesting. Alright. Oh, that was a really good shot. Nice. Yeah, the first kind of world of the game is my favorite because it's fairly easy, whereas the later levels I think are a little bit too hard for my taste. I'm a pretty casual golf player. Well, golf game player. I've never tried real golf. I don't think I would enjoy it. Oops, that was bad. Really? Ouch. Oh. No, okay. Let's try that again. Oh no, I missed one. Is that gonna be a problem? Do I need to get them all to 100% it or something? I don't know. Maybe it doesn't matter. Maybe I just need enough to finish the level. I want the DNA. Am I out of energy? Am I gonna die? I unlocked Cheese Ball. What does Cheese Ball do? I'll have to try out some of the other balls later. Oh, it's this map. I hate this one. Thank you. No. I got pretty lucky the first time I played this, and I managed to get it really easily. But on the stream, I'm having pretty bad luck here. How am I supposed to get these? You know what? I'm just gonna play this level normally and ignore the DNA. Let's see. So what does DNA actually do? I get more points for collecting DNA. I get more points for having energy. I think that's just how much energy I have at the end of each round. Not really sure how well I did. I guess I just have to try to get more of the DNA that I missed while also using less strokes. But I wonder if it's worth using an extra stroke or two to get more DNA. Probably not, because DNA is only worth 500 points and energy is worth more. I don't know. I'll figure it out later. I'm gonna go back to playing the... Hold on. Gonna go back to Geometry Trips. Because it looks like there's a lot of levels here that I haven't played yet. So let's continue with this. It looks like, there's a lot of these. I've only done 21%. Okay. Alright. Well, I'm probably not going to talk very much while playing this because, I'll try to chill out and concentrate on the game instead of just talking. But, you know, I'm probably not going to be very good regardless. I don't know. You can watch the game and see how it goes. Or just leave it running in the background. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.